Okay, so Meta is on a roll, following up on their Llama 3 release last week. This week, they've decided to move back to computer vision, and they've released the SAM 2 model. So I normally don't cover a lot of computer vision stuff in here. I try to cover some of it, but I have to say this model is pretty amazing at what it can do. And I just want to talk a little bit about both the model and how this model is changing a lot of the sort of predictive AI. So while lately people have mostly been focused on generative AI, whether that's generating words, whether that's generating images, whether that's generating audio, etc., there's still a huge field that needs predictive AI, that needs to be able to look at an image and say what's in that image. And not just do it with a VLM or something, but precisely be able to say with bounding boxes, with segmentation masks, what is actually there. And this brings us to the SAM 2 model. So last year, Meta released SAM, and this stands for Segment Anything Model. And the idea here was that you could basically use this model to segment everything in an image and to be able to get really good results doing that for a variety of classes, not just what the model had been trained on. So traditionally, segmentation models and object detection models are trained on specific classes so that they know how to segment cars in an image, or they know how to segment people in an image. Where this model is really cool is that it allows you to be able to prompt the model with an example of what you actually want it to segment, and then it can basically do the segmenting, meaning that you don't necessarily need a whole bunch of example training data if you're trying to do segmentation on something that's perhaps a little bit unusual and that there is no custom model already trained for that. Now, if we jump forward to today, Meta has released SAM 2. And what this does is basically take the whole thing to a new level by allowing you to use it for videos. And on top of that, they've improved the model in many ways as well. So let's jump in and have a look. So some of the key takeaways here is that this is a model for real-time video. I think it can do inference of up to 44 frames a second on some decent hardware. Again, you can basically prompt it on what you want it to find. It will then be able to use not just single images, but actually to basically use the video to track what it is that you want to track in here and segment what it is you want to segment, etc. Another cool thing is that this model is being released along with code and weights, but with the model weights are actually being released with an Apache 2 license here. So that continues Mark Zuckerberg's ambition of just making this kind of AI and these models easily available for free to lots of people. So companies that have perhaps been trying to do this as a product and licensing these models with restrictive licenses and stuff like that, really many of them are going to be out of luck now that this kind of model is just out there and anyone can use this. On top of the model, Meta has also released a data set. Now, this is a data set of 51,000 videos and more than 600,000 different, what they're calling masklets, right? So these little spatio-temporal masks in here. So one of the big things that they've done here is they've unified the architecture. So if we look at this diagram in here, we can see that they've basically simplified a lot of it from having a image encoder through this memory to basically the mask decoders, and then this sort of feeding back. This idea of this temporal sort of memory in here is really cool. And I wonder where we're going to see this also show up in other modalities. So if we compare that to the original SAM architecture, we can see that a lot of this has been simplified, and we can see that the whole new issue around the memory is a key factor to what's going on here. One of the biggest things of this model is going to be doing things like allowing you to make data sets for training your own specialized object detection models or segmentation models. So you can see in the example here how simple it is to basically select that they want the t-shirt, but they don't want the guy's head in here as well as it goes through. So amazingly, some of the stats that have come out of this is that this model is not only doing better, but it's actually 6 times faster than the previous SAM model for a number of different things. They mentioned the whole inference with SAM 2 feels real time at approximately 44 frames per second. And like I mentioned before, this is going to open up to make it a lot easier for people to do annotation of data for these kind of things. So that you'll be able to annotate just by selecting an area to prompt of what you want it to follow, or just clicking to have it follow something. So let's jump in and have a look at the demo and have a play with that. Okay, so if we come in and have a look at the demo that Meta has put up here, I'm going to pick this particular one here. It will then do a video. And you can also upload your own video, which I'll look at later on. Let's come through. Let's say we want to track the ball. Okay, so let's get a frame where we've got the ball available. Okay, I don't want that background. Okay, so I've got the ball there, basically in the frame. And at the same time, let's add another object where we'll track the dog. Okay, so you can see that we've got those two selected and they're nicely done in the segmentation. We can basically now just run it through and you can see that it's tracking both the dog and the ball. Let's just pause it where it's seeing the ball. We can see that it's basically tracking the ball there. It's tracking the dog and doing those. Now, we can then basically start to play around with some different things in here. So if we want to take the background, and let's say we didn't want to see this girl or something like that, we can take that and just pixelate it. So now we can see the dog, we can see the ball, but everything else has been pixelated in here. Now, one of the cool things with a model like this here is if you have a conventional segmentation model that was trained for birds, it wouldn't work on cartoons. Yet you can see with this model, it's able to get all of that and we can then just highlight the cartoon that we want. So we can see that where it's being obfuscated, we can see where the clouds are passing over it, but we can see that, okay, we've got the actual bird in there. And by playing around with the different effects in the background, we can actually come up with a whole bunch of different sort of creative ideas for this as well. Okay, so this time I'm basically uploading a video of the man of the hour, Mark Zuckerberg himself. And you can see that, okay, it's pretty low res video, but we can see if we wanted to basically track him, we can track him on the hydrofoil no problem at all. And you can see that this is not one of their demos. This is something I've uploaded myself and it's working fine in here. Then if we wanted to do different kind of effects and stuff like that, we can do all of that. And we can use the segmentation effect, but for doing something generative here. So what this basically, this burst effect is doing is that it's just sort of working out the center of the segmentation area and then projecting out from that, like we can see in there. We could also then just track his head this time. And if we want to replace that with an emoji, I'm not sure he would be unhappy. I think he's probably going to be happy here. You can see we can basically have an emoji going through doing this. Now, this is just using the SAM model to basically do the segmentation of his head. And then they're overlaying an emoji on the top. Very nice. A little effect and something that actually is probably quite useful for a lot of YouTubers who film out in public and want to hide people's faces or something like that. I think a lot of YouTubers use quite expensive software for doing that kind of thing. You could imagine that this is going to be built into a lot of different things going forward here. All right. So finally, if you want to actually do this with code as well, Meta has basically uploaded some example notebooks here. So we can see just the standard sort of automatic mass generation here, showing you using the model, doing a bunch of different sort of segments in here. Okay, so in the second notebook, they've basically got an example of where you prompt it with a point, right? So you can see here that if we come and take this picture of a car and we just give it, this is obviously the dimensions of the image of the car. We basically pass in where we want the sort of point to be, in this case, on this back window. It can then work out the various masks and gives us a score for these. So you can see the first mask is like these two windows joined. The second one is just this particular one. And the third one is the full truck in here. So what you can do is you can actually give it some multiple points. So in this case, now we've got 2 points in there. So it's working out, okay, what mask would basically cover both those points? And that would be the truck in here. From that, you can see the masking is extremely accurate through to the exhaust, the tires, etc. is going through here. Just like on the videos where you can have a positive mask and a negative mask, you can also do that here. So basically having this point excluding it means that it's not going to find the car anymore. It's going to go for the window like we had before. You can see that they've also given it where you can basically put in a number of points or a box for a bounding box and it can find a wheel. It can do a variety of different things like this. The last notebook that they've put in here is for doing video segmentation. So this allows you to actually take a video and then run it through. You can see the point here is basically finding the boy's shorts or clothing. By giving a second point, it now is able to find the full part of the boy, and then it can track it right through various frames. Even when the girl is occluding the boy, it's still able to work out that he's there, and then as he comes back into frame, it's showing him in here. They also have examples in here of segmenting multiple objects. So you can see that they're segmenting out different pieces of clothing on the two kids, and it's able to track those as they're bouncing up and down on this bed in here. Obviously, for doing those fancy effects and stuff, you could just use something like OpenCV and play with it in there. So overall, this model is, you know, extremely impressive at what it can do. And if you are doing anything with computer vision, you should certainly look at using this. Even if you're not actually going to run the model for your particular task, you can use this to annotate data for training a faster model or for using a different model in this kind of thing. So you could imagine that we could use the SAM to annotate a lot of data, and then we use something smaller like the Florence 2 model for doing something specific in there. Overall, I'd say that it's just fantastic to see that Meta is making so many of these models open, giving them pretty good licenses that people can use for both for commercial as well as research uses, and building not only on the large language models being available to people, but allowing people to use these predictive AI models for things like computer vision, etc. Anyway, as always, if you've got any comments or questions, put them in the comments below here. If you found the video useful, please click like and subscribe. I'm told that it helps a lot in getting more people to see these videos. And I will talk to you again in the next video. Bye for now.